Hello, this is Mr. Davis, and these are the Style Pile Notes. These notes are a series of lessons that are designed to help writers add sentence variety and style to their writing so that we can go beyond simple sentences such as, "My dog ran," to more complicated and stylish structures like, "My dog, the beautiful, courageous pug, ran hideously slow." These lessons are brief, free of overly complicated grammar jargon, and should be accessible for all learners. So, what do you need to do these style pile notes? If you're in my class, ask for a copy, or if you're not in my class, print a copy of the style pile notes. Here's how it works. Watch the lessons while filling in your notes. You only need the parts that are in red font. If you want to take down more notes than what's in the red font, you're free to do so. Okay, today's style pile video is going to focus on rhetorical questions. Wouldn't it be great to figure out how to use rhetorical questions? So in your first box that says, what is it? I want you to write rhetorical question. Wouldn't it be nice to know the rules for using a rhetorical question? So there really are two things I want you to know about rhetorical questions. First of all, a rhetorical question is a question that is asked for effect, meaning you're not really expecting an answer when you ask a rhetorical question in your writing or when you're speaking. The second rule or example I want you to know about is that the answer is usually obvious to the audience, or if it's not obvious, the question's usually immediately answered by the writer. So in those previous slides, when I was asking you all those questions about wouldn't it be great to know the rules about for using a rhetorical question, that in and of itself was a rhetorical question. I was using it as an example, but we've got this example down on the bottom as well. This is probably the most famous example of a rhetorical question. If all your friends jumped off a bridge, would you too? When somebody asks you that question, whether it be a parent or a teacher, they're not expecting an answer like, "Well, yeah, maybe I would jump off a bridge because it would get kind of lonely if I was by myself." They're not expecting an answer, right? You might have a smart aleck answer like that. But in reality, they're asking that question to kind of prove the point that, oh yeah, I'm supposed to think for myself. I'm not just supposed to go along with what the crowd is saying or doing. So it's a question, a rhetorical question that's asked for effect. The answer is supposed to be obvious to you. You're not supposed to provide one. All right, here's another example of a rhetorical question. Shouldn't we want to make the world a better place for future generations? If I were delivering a speech and I started with this rhetorical question, I wouldn't expect the audience to shout out an answer, because the answer should be obvious. I doubt anybody would go, "No, I want to mess the planet up for future generations. I hate my kids," or something like that, right? Most of us, the answer would be, well, yeah, we want to make the world a better place for future generations. Therefore, it's a rhetorical question, not only because I don't expect an answer, but the answer should be pretty obvious to my audience. Okay, so now to your third box, the use it box. I want you to pause the video and ask a rhetorical question you could use to persuade your teacher to not give you any homework today. So think of a rhetorical question you could use to try to persuade your teacher not to give you any homework today. All right, here's just one example of what it could look like. Don't you have better things to do than sit around grading all of this homework? It's a question I could use to try to persuade my teacher not to give me any homework. Fortunately for me, I am the teacher, so I get to assign the homework. The downside is, though, I have to grade it. So here are two examples of rhetorical questions in case you want some more examples. This first one's a pretty famous historical example from Sojourner Truth. She delivers a speech and it gives you the context of the speech so you can kind of understand her rhetorical question, "Ain't I a woman?" She says it again and again throughout that speech, a really excellent speech, by the way. The second one is just kind of like a funny rhetorical question that makes you think, oh yeah, I guess I hadn't considered that before. Okay, your job now, add rhetorical questions to add style and flair to your writing. When it comes to your rhetorical questions, you don't want to add a million of them to your writing, because don't you hate it when some people overdo it? Thank you for using these style pile notes. If you have any questions about rhetorical questions, don't hesitate to ask your teacher.